The ocean isn't the same at every depth. Its chemistry transforms in ways that impacts marine life, global climate, and even deep sea explorations. Understanding this shift is essential for marine science, climate studies, and the conservation of the ocean ecosystem. Welcome to Ocean Science. Today we will explore how the ocean chemistry changes with depth. We can divide the ocean in different layers depending on his characteristics. We will talk about surface waters, and it's not only the surface part that we see when we see the ocean. It's the place that goes from zero, so the surface level, until 200 meters down. Here we will have high levels of oxygen for the phytoplankton and the photosynthesis, a warm temperature from the sun that heats the water and becomes less dense than the water below. As we have interaction with the atmosphere, we will have more CO2 exchange, so higher concentrations of this component. And for the biological activity that we have in this place, we will have low levels of nutrients. Between the 200 meters and 1000 meters, we will have the thermaline and the helocline, two points that indicate the change on the temperature and the salinity. The thermocline indicates a rapid decrease on the temperature, and the helocline indicates a rapid increase on the salinity. Here we have less light penetration, so we will have less photosynthesis activity. Here we can have also the oxygen minimum zone. Occurs due to the respiration exceeding oxygen replacement, and the levels of CO2 increase for the organic matter decomps. After this zone, we have the zone known as deep ocean, between 1000 and 4000 meters. Here we will have constant and cold temperatures between 2 and 4 degrees. Here we will have high pressure, around 400 times the atmospheric pressure, and we will have here a high concentration on nutrients due to the breakdown of sinking organic materials. This phenomena is known as marine snow, and we will talk about it in a future video. The CO2 concentration increases, so here we will have waters more acid, so the pH levels decrease. The dissolved oxygen increases because of the ocean currents that brings these concentrations from the poles. So after this point, we will have the abyssal and the hadal zones, so more than 4000 meters. Here we will have temperatures near to the freezing point and extreme pressure, around 1000 times the atmospheric pressure. The chemical of these waters are stable and the circulation is very slow, and we can find chemosynthetic life in the hydrothermal vent zone. And the dissolved oxygen can be limited in certain points at this depth. So we see the different classifications that we can have on the ocean waters, and we see how the marine life can adapt to these different concentrations and variation on the chemicals. With this stratification, we see how the role of the ocean currents is essential, because without this, the oxygen will be in one part and the nutrients in another one. So it will be so difficult for life to evolve in these situations. With the actual human impact, we have different effects as the ocean acidification, and this changed the game. Here, if we change the concentration of CO2 before the normal cycles that we have in the ocean, everything will change. And this, of course, affects to the marine life and all the food web. Another thing that we can find on the deepest part of the ocean is plastic. And here we don't know what are the effects in a long-term period. In conclusion, we see how we have different sub-ecosystems inside our ocean. And here we see how each one of the organisms adapts to live in these situations. But we don't know which will be the future of this with the actual human impact. So more research are needed for this. That is all for today. Thank you for watching. If you like this content, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you the next Saturday at 12 with the next video. Bye bye.